Hello and welcome. My name is Avi. I've been wanting to make this video for quite some time, actually. I want to simply share my own home practice when I only have around 10 minutes or so in my day. Maybe my day is busy, but my body just wants a little bit of hatha yoga practice. So I developed a lot of these movements simply from listening to the body. So I believe that the body has an innate intelligence to it. So instead of thinking in the mind, I'm going to do this and then I'm going to do that, the only question I'm asking is what feels good. And often I'll notice what areas of the body are tight, and the body will just respond and move in the way that it wants to. So I invite you to do the exact same thing. All of our bodies are different. The best thing about becoming a yoga teacher is that it gave me permission to actually get down on the floor and move my body however I felt. I know that for many people, that's just something we don't do. But the body wants to extend and stretch and twist and move in lots of different ways. And I'm amazed constantly at the difference in how I feel before my practice and after. So again, this is like the bare minimum for me that I try to get in my day, 10 minutes in the morning or so, and I'll share it with you. Most importantly, adapt, adjust to what might serve, okay? This is where I'm at in my level. Often there's ways to accommodate yourself, but I really just want to inspire you to develop this own practice, your own individual hatha yoga practice, and take you through some of my motions. If you like any of them, if they feel good, use them. I normally do begin with meditation, pranayama, breathing exercises. So I think that's a great way to start. Those probably also last maybe around 10 minutes total, maybe 5 minutes of pranayama and then 5-10 minutes of meditation. It depends on what my day is like, how early I got up, all of that. But I'm just gonna focus on the physical practice right now and move from there. So first thing I do is normally I just like come forward into child's pose, extending the arms, relaxing, always relaxing. So I hope you're doing this right now. Just take your time, get on the floor, extend the arms forward. And this is one of my favorite positions. I could just be here for so long, noticing the breath. And then eventually I'll come up forward to tabletop position. I'll slide my meditation cushion out. And then I'll start to just move forward, back, side to side. Just this whole area is like my landscape of discovery. I love to move in circles here. You can even draw figure eights. But the body is just telling me what to do. I'm not using my mind. Maybe I'll do a few cat-cows. Maybe I'll shift the hips side to side. And I'm not going to do it today, but often I'll do some push-ups too. So even coming to a plank position can be really beneficial. I like to work out the chest, so I'll just do some push-ups, really just to massage, gain strength, and then press back to downward facing dog. If this is too much to you, feel free to come down on your knees. Notice the foundation of your hands, maybe spreading the fingers wide. You want to feel a nice strong foundation. Back down dog, forward to plank, swaying those hips. And spending a little time in down dog, I really like to bend the knees deeply. Lift the heels, drop the heels. And then I'm going to prepare to come forward to lunge. So I like to take a big step forward. I always switch whether I'm bringing my right foot back, right foot forward first, or left foot forward. Today I'll bring my right foot forward. If it's too much, you can drop the knee into a low lunge. I go straight to a high lunge. My body can do it. It feels good for me. And then I lift the torso up and I just love to be here for a little while. No rush at all. Little micro adjustments, extending the heel towards the floor, bending the knee to that right position. Noticing the breath. I love to extend the chest forward, shoulders back, arms come out. I do a lot of movements you'll see with my hands like this, with the fingers. Again, the body is just telling me what to do, rolling the wrist, not really using the mind. Extend the arms above the head. I love this. And then next, I usually come probably forward into what I would call a more advanced pose, but you do what feels right. You can have a block next to your foot. You can bring the back leg a little bit forward so it's not off the ground, but I come into a balancing posture and I extend both arms out. I extend the back leg out. So I'm like reaching in all directions, feeling into the crown of my head, balancing here, maybe rotating the wrist. Then just for a few breaths, I'll extend the arms forward as well. This is like my general sequence that I do. And I'll bring the other leg forward, roll the ankle. I love to bend the knee, rotate that whole leg, both directions. Sometimes I'll sway the arms and that leg forward and back. And eventually I'll come to do a bit of a thigh stretch. Stretching the quadricep. This to me is really important. Sometimes I'll come forward, extend the arm, bend the knee a little bit. But I'm really just focusing on the thigh. And I'm pressing the top of the back foot into the hand. All the while balancing. Little extension, bring that foot back. Now I'm in standing position. I love to do this circular motion of the torso. It's probably my favorite thing. My wife calls it the loop-de-loop. I like to rotate the arms, little shake, and get ready for the other side. I'll just take a big step back with the other foot. Same thing, take time in the lunge. When I'm ready, shifting my weight forward, feeling well balanced in the front leg. Again, adjust accordingly to your needs. Come forward here. Always micro adjustments. The body just always has something to say, I find. I'm also not a believer that you have to do everything the same on one side as you do on the other side. That's very limiting. And all the time we do things with one arm or one leg, and we don't do it with the other one. Think of a pitcher in baseball. How many times do they throw with one arm? So it's okay. You know, general balance, but it doesn't have to be exactly the same. Come to standing, extend the arms back, rotating the hips. I love this so much. Arms, maybe side to side. I like to come up on my tippy toes to lift the heels. This really stretches different parts of the leg muscles that I don't really do anywhere else. Deep breathing. I might separate the legs and just do a little side-to-side stretch here. I like to come into a squatting position. Extend the legs forward, forward fold here. I always bend the knee a lot. Again, not a right or a wrong, just playing around with what feels right for you. Deep breathing. And eventually, I'll come onto my back, getting on my back is like extremely important. I need to do it on my back. I'll just like to roll around and kind of massage all the areas of the back, get into the nooks and crannies. Roll the ankles here. You play with different positions. Sometimes I like to have the feet together as I rock to side to side, then more of like a happy baby pose you could do. Just being playful, noticing what feels right. And then eventually I'll extend the legs forward and I'll leave them hovering. This is my core practice that I do. And if you need to allow the feet to come down, you can rest, it's fine, and then maybe bring them back up. And this is somewhat challenging. When I first started, I would only do it for a few seconds. Now I can do it for a bit longer. I do a certain type of meditation, I guess, when I'm here, where I feel the whole body and I just try to relax and deep breathing, just be with the challenge of it, allow the challenge to be okay. It's one of those feelings where it's strenuous, but the strain feels good. Those muscles are working that don't normally work. And then eventually I'll transition into a sort of fish pose, we call it. So you can tuck the hands, the palms underneath the glutes. And then I lift the head up and back and I lift the chest up and the whole spine is arching, especially the lumbar spine. I don't know anything else that really kind of gets to it quite like this. Feels great. I still have my legs lifted, but you can bring the legs down here. It's fine. And just concentrate on the spine. And then I'll relax, release. You could have even done that with the legs on the floor. It doesn't matter, but I like to keep them lifted as well. Then here, reaching in all directions. I'll do some twisting over to each side. Sometimes with the knees bent, extending the arms out, and maybe extending the legs. Extend the arms above the head. You can see I'm just always kind of in constant motion. I mean, I hold sometimes too when it feels right. But I like this kind of just the fluid nature to all of the movement. Go over to the other side. Because this is only when I have a short period of time. I don't have much time. So I want to get to all the different areas. Well, eventually I'll be done with my back. Come forward too, another forward fold. Maybe I'll bring the bottoms of the feet together. Try to feel the whole body. Notice if you can do that, just closing the eyes. See if you can feel the whole body. It has a certain effect on me when I do that. I try to remember to often. And so the next thing I'll do, getting ready to kind of finish up, I like to do another leg strengthening practice. So I come to a crouching position and then like an elevator, I'll just slowly begin to extend the legs. I like to lift the heels here. The heels can be on the floor. Of course, anything is possible. And I like to just maybe hold a little bit, check the posture of the spine, deep breathing. Eventually, I'll extend the legs all the way. Again, I'll do a little tippy toe exercise. I'll do a little bit more here, a little more arm movements. A little more leg movements, the hips. I'm ready to start my day. That's it. Thanks for joining me. Take care. Leave me questions if you have them. Again, I so hope that you develop your own practice. I think that's where it's at. Listen to the body. Until next time.